In this week's head-to-head, we have two luxury vans that have received a facelift and other additional changes to them. We're talking about the latest generation Toyota Alphard and Honda Odyssey. Find out here what puts them on the list of the most sought-after cars these days. Watch this.
Let's first check the oily bits of the Toyota Alphard and the Honda Odyssey. Under the hood of the Alphard is a 3.5-liter V6 engine that gives out 296 PS of power and 361 Nm of torque, and is mated to an 8-speed automatic transmission. On the other hand, the Odyssey EX-V Navi runs on a 2.4-liter DOHC Inline-4 engine that produces 175 PS and 226 Nm of torque. This engine is coupled with a continuously variable transmission. For the suspension, it comes with a MacPherson Strut with stabilizers at the front and a Double Wishbone with Coil Springs at the rear. Its suspension setup is composed of a MacPherson Strut at the front and Torsion Axle Beam at the rear. Let's now take a closer look at the exterior details of our featured cars. For the Alphard, there's a number of exterior details that don't look familiar. Starting with the front fascia, the Alphard comes with a bigger grille and is further highlighted by this new set of headlights. The logo at the front is new as well, and it adds character to the Alphard. Meanwhile, the rear houses this new set of signal lamps, an additional detail that completes the whole look. The Alphard powers through the road with 18-inch alloy wheels. Meanwhile, the same with the Alphard, the exterior of the Odyssey is filled with enhanced details. First, the look is highlighted by Honda's latest design language, which features a new aero bumper that is matched with a new dark front grille. This front design also comes with LED headlights and LED daytime running lights. On the side, the look is highlighted by the 17-inch alloy wheels. It's time to hop into the Alphard and the Odyssey. As you go inside the Alphard, one thing that would easily catch your attention is the leather-clad captain seats with ottoman. Also, the majority of the Alphard's interior is wrapped in a premium wood grain trim, complemented by matte chrome and black piano wood inserts. Moreover, if talking about comfort, the Alphard comes with an ample space for legroom for the passengers in the second and third row. Moreover, the tri-zone automatic climate control is a staple feature in the Alphard. For the infotainment system, the Alphard is equipped with the standard touchscreen display and navigation. It comes with the standard 2-DIN 8-speaker sound system that is available in AM/FM, CD, DVD, MP3, AUX, USB, and Bluetooth connectivity, among others. Meanwhile, inside the Odyssey, the captain cradle seats with ottoman will also catch your attention in a sense that it looks so elegant. Everything else is wrapped in leather upholstery as well, providing added comfort to the driver and passengers. The second row seats are kit with long sliding, reclined with articulating backrest, and while the third row, you'll find 3-person individual recline with 3 pieces of headrest. Adding highlight to the interior of the Odyssey, it's an infotainment system that is composed of 7-inch touchscreen display audio with navigation that offers Bluetooth, an HDMI port, USB-in connectivity, and has 6 speakers. To top it off, a 9-inch rear entertainment system with an HDMI port and DVD and your setup for any road trip. When it comes to safety and security, both the Alphard and the Odyssey come with necessary features. The Alphard is equipped with 7 airbags, hill start assist, vehicle stability control, and anti-lock braking system, among other features. On the other hand, the Odyssey comes with additional technology safety features on top of Honda's standard ones. It includes smart parking assist system with new sensor-based back-in, parallel-in, and parallel-out feature, multi-view camera system with dynamic guidelines, and the cross-traffic monitor blind spot information.
Toyota Alphard and Honda Odyssey, two cars that prove that changes should always be welcome. Whichever you go for, know that it's a good choice. That's it for our head-to-head this week.